What we're trying to find is something that's very rare. So we're expecting one of these single top quarks in about 20 billion collisions of protons on antiprotons at this giant particle accelerator in Chicago. So there's, first of all, right now only one place in the world that can make these top quarks. And we have two experiments that are live across the ring, this accelerator ring, from each other. And partly we are doing cross-checks of each other, or this is, we work on the same kind of physics processes, but we use slightly different technologies, and it's independent scientists on each one. So we use similar techniques to look at similar types of physics processes, but with completely independent cross-checks, different sets of data, and different manpower. So this is one way, when we are looking for something that's 1 in 20 billion, you can make sure that you've actually found what you thought you were looking for. MSU is unique in that it's one of the few universities in the world that's on both of these two experiments. And in fact, it's the only university that has colleagues or professors from MSU that were working on searching for the single top on both of the experiments. So myself and Dr. Schwienhorst have been looking and working on this for 3 or 4 years.
This all happens at Fermilab in principle, but for us, it's not just a lot of resources that we need in terms of working with people and having different people all contributing, but it's also resources on the intellectual side, working with Professor Yuan from Michigan State, who guided us in how exactly we should analyze the data and exactly what we should look for, and also using computing resources, both a large computer cluster we have here at Michigan State that we've used to both prepare samples for this analysis and to also to do the final analysis, but then really also running on computer clusters all over the world. Several of us here at Michigan State are actually involved in doing a follow-up analysis of exactly the single-top search at the LHC at CERN, and so we're looking forward to not just understanding what it is, but really going beyond it and understanding top quarks at a much, much deeper level at the LHC.
We are all familiar with this Einstein equation equal mc squared, and we know about c, the speed of light, and that so many people know about the special relativity. But, and also that we know about the energy, however, we don't really know about the mass, m. And the whole this object of the electric century breaking is to do with the understanding of this mass, where does this mass come from? And the reason that the top quark is so heavy, as heavy as this, what we call the vacuum expectation value, and which is, has the deep connection to the mass generation, still unknown. And that's a very important question. And once we know about that, then we could then go back and then to understand the whole evolution of the universe, because that's described today by the standard model, and plus some additional things such as dark matter we have not yet found.
Being involved in a discovery is something unique that doesn't happen to every grad student. So yeah, I'm very excited that I was involved in this project, and I'm happy that everything came out the way it